My name is Dr. Robert Smith. I'm a professor in the Department of Mathematics and Statistics at the University of Ottawa, but I'm also cross-appointed to the Faculty of Medicine, where I'm in the Department of Epidemiology, and I have been at the University of Ottawa for 11 years now. So my research involves taking real-world problems in infectious diseases and translating them into the language of mathematics. And I do think of it as a language. So the idea is that you have a very dense language, but it's very useful because you have access to logic and rigor. And so it means that you can analyze these problems in a way that you probably couldn't so easily in the real world. And so it kind of gives you a way to shine the light in the darkness. And this means, in my case, I use differential equations, which are essentially an engine of change. And so you build this engine based on your understanding of the biology, the mechanisms involved in sort of how people interact or cells interact with virus or whatever it is that you're under study, and then try and come to some conclusion. And that conclusion may be, quarantine this many people, or it may be vaccinate these many people, or the conclusion may be, we're all in big trouble, depending on what the situation is. And then you can actually compare this with data, kind of go back to the real world and see sort of how this has an effect. I also work with people who are biologists or epidemiologists or government people and so on, because they help me with this translation. So once I have the mathematical model, I can do the math and I can solve the problems, and my students and I work on these all the time. But actually getting the translation between the real world and the mathematics is difficult, and trying to get it very, accurately is even more difficult sometimes. So either I use my own experience or I draw on other people who can do this, so that we can sort of have a better understanding of kind of essentially how to get a handle on diseases. And I'm particularly interested in how you intervene. So what can you do to actually change this? Like, where can you, take a better drug regimen or vaccinate, more often, or spray insecticide, or whatever it is that you're actually trying to sort of, tackle, can you do this? So one of the great things about mathematics is, I guess, like crystal balls, it can predict the future. So it's one of the very few things we have that actually tell us what's going to happen in any kind of reliable way. So of course, it's not perfect. It depends on the assumptions that you have to try and see, okay, given those assumptions, what's going to happen, but you can actually roll it out. And so to me, that's the great power of mathematics. So what I'm trying to do all the time is basically say, if this disease, either exists currently or turns up in the future or something like that, what's going to happen? What are the effects? And so I'm always trying to predict, long-term outcomes, short-term outcomes, and so on, but not just a single outcome. Often you want to predict a variety of outcomes. Say, okay, given, all the uncertainty that we have in the world, what are the possible outcomes? Which also tells you what is not going to happen. So that's actually also very useful too. So for example, I've used this in the past to look at the HPV vaccine. So the human papillomavirus vaccine came out in about 2004, and it was rolled out in Ontario in 2008. And so we looked at, along with Public Health Agency of Canada, what would be the effects of kind of standardizing this vaccine across Canada? Do we need to? It's given at different ages and in different number of doses and so on. We discovered that the ages was not that relevant, but the number of doses actually turns out you don't need as many doses as was sort of predicted, in the sense that you're better off having fewer doses that more people take than more doses that fewer take. And so, in fact, Quebec changed its policy as a result of this modeling. And that's just one example of lots and lots of applications that we do. I'm a very applied mathematician, and so I've worked with people in Africa on spraying insecticide to combat malaria. I worked on a lot of HIV problems throughout the world, leprosy, all kinds of things, actually, because I find that the interface between math and biology is, for me, very rewarding. I really, really like the way they join together, and I really like that actually my sort of theoretical tools in mathematics can be something that's so useful in kind of dealing with world problems. And that to me is extremely rewarding.